What simple life hack should everyone know? Get into a routine of stretching your hip flexors and chest if you sit for long periods. Absolute game changer for people who suffer with chronic lower back pain as a result of being hunched over a desk. 5 minutes of daily exercise is infinitely better than 0 minutes and will make a big difference. Google it first. No matter how good a person you are, at some point you will be the bad guy in someone else's story. You can't please everyone. And you shouldn't try to be a good person and have friendships with people you can respect and look up to. If there's a jar or container you can't open, run the lid under hot water for 30 seconds. Dry it so you can get a good grip. Then open. Never had this not work. Some pretty good stuff on here. If you have trouble choosing, flip a coin. While you're waiting to get the result, your mind automatically starts to wish for what it wants. Then you can choose easily. Don't take criticism from someone you wouldn't take advice from. Edit. You've taken my advice. Take my criticism. Reddit awards are dumb. You should support a local brewery instead. Buy anything you'd need in your kitchen from a restaurant supply store. Anything. Plates. Glasses. Pans, etc. There are a few online that sell to consumers. Those $8.99 tongs at a box store are like $1.30. 16 ounces. Mason jar glass that sells for $3 to $4 a piece can be bought as a 12-pack case for $8.55. Oneida China plates that sell for $345.84 a case for $57.84. I just bought a 2-foot by 2-foot wooden butcher's block cutting board that would have been close to $400 for $55. Edit. Also, this shit is built to last years in a commercial kitchen under constant use. It sure as shit can handle your Sunday brunch cooking ass. Edit 2. I've been buying from here. https://www.websteronstore.com. Edit 3. For those asking about the EU. Replied. www.hughjordan.com if you're in Ireland. Best site and fast delivery. Edit 4. Yowza. I'll get to responding to all of the questions this week. Thank you for the gold. Platinum et. Al, but no more please and thank you to those that reached out looking to tip on apps or Bitcoin. Please consider donating to my favorite charity instead, Project Pinball. They provide and maintain pinball machines free of charge to long-term children's hospitals and take donations. Sell merch or if you're feeling lucky. They run 2 continuous raffles at $50 and $75 a ticket that close every 200 sold, where the winner gets a brand new pinball machine shipped to them. Most of life is just showing up to things. If you put something down temporarily, say out loud, I've put the screwdriver by the microwave, or whatever. This engages many more areas of the brain, particularly the language centers, which creates a richer memory, making it less likely you'll forget where you put it. Brush your teeth more thoroughly before bed after you are done eating and drinking for the day. Morning brushing is important too. But more so for fresh breath, while evening cleaning will prevent bacteria from breeding and damaging your teeth and gums. If you want to wear something white, light in color, wear underwear that matches the color of your skin. Not white. Sometimes changing your pillowcase daily can help with acne. I use a clean t-shirt over my pillow to accomplish the same effect. If you ever fall off a ship, ferry, at sea and were lucky enough to be spotted, don't try to swim your way to safety. The more you try to swim, the lesser the chances of survival. Just try to keep afloat and conserve energy and body heat while rescue team do what they're supposed to. Unless you are in hypothermic waters, the best bet always is to stay afloat without trying to swim to somewhere. This information about falling overboard, hypothermia and conditions, survival at sea, etc. are based on my own experience of 12 years sailing on merchant ships like this. P.S. Link will take you to a time-lapse video I made when crossing, sailing under the Golden Gate Bridge in San Francisco, USA. This kind of ship is called a container ship. Honey does not go bad. If it has gone solid, it has just crystallized and can become liquid again with just a little heat. Not necessarily a hack, per se, but learn some basic knife skills. The amount of time you will save chopping vegetables a few times a week. Minimum. For the rest of your life far outweighs the amount of time it takes to learn. Plus you can use the extra time to keep the kitchen clean, and that makes everything less stressful while you're cooking and makes the cleanup faster as well. Turn your bed mattress when you renew your blanket. Through time your mattress will deform and that can make you sleep worse. Edit. Some mattress have a specific side and top that they need to be. Thanks for pointing that out. Train yourself to always keep an eye out for things that need to go in the direction you are going. If you are about to go downstairs, does any item nearby need to go with you? Perhaps a cup can be brought to the sink on your way to the bathroom. To confirm which circuit breaker is associated to an outlet, plug in an old radio and turn the volume up before you flip the circuit breaker. If you bring something to someone's house that you don't want to forget, put your keys with it, assuming you can trust the people there. Also, get a tile or similar Bluetooth device so you never lose your keys or phone again. Whenever you have a time to be somewhere, aim to be there 15 minutes early. To allow for time snags or for traffic, people respect punctuality. Read the 3 and 4 star reviews for the most reliable information on Amazon items. If you have a spare minute or are just playing video games or on a computer at home, take a few minutes to just pet your dog, cat, and really appreciate them. A phrase I heard somewhere just really stuck with me. Pets are only a part of your life, but you are your pet's entire life. You will often have to make decisions in life without being able to know all the information related to the choices. Being able to identify what you don't know is invaluable. It allows you to make assumptions and contingency plans if those assumptions fail. I want to slap every person that quips. If you assume, you make an ass out of you and me. You cannot function in life without making assumptions. The trick is to identify them as such so that you can be better prepared when they are resolved. Most of the time, keeping your mouth shut is a great option. Manners and general politeness will get you far and become the norm with but a small amount of practice. I'm not talking overboard, m'lady, but a simple please and thank you with a genuine smile. When moving house, always set up your bedroom, make the bed first so when you're exhausted and just had enough you can fall into bed. Nothing worse than being exhausted and having to make the bed before getting into it. Edit. Good grief. That blew up. Thank you for the awards. Edit 2. To all the grammar Nazis. I apologize profusely for using your instead of your. I don't always proofread as well as I should. But please. Get a grip. It's a typo, not axe murder. Turn natural peanut butter, the ones where the oil separates and you have to mix it, upside down for a few hours. It will bring the oil to the top and make it a lot easier to mix. Then, after you mix it, put it in the fridge and the cold will solidify the oil so you don't have to mix it again. Edit. To a few points. Natural peanut butter doesn't solidify to a point that it's hard to spread when cold, so that's not something you have to worry about when storing it in the fridge. To the person who said just buy emulsified. I mean sure, but Adam's peanut butter is best peanut butter. And I know someone was going to call out my a lot. Haha. Not really a life hack, but a general advice. Do what works for you. It doesn't matter if it's unconventional. If it works, it works. I have ADHD, and for me that means keeping things organized is difficult AF. I also have a hard time remembering pretty much anything. I keep my laundry in boxes underneath my bed, organized by color. That way I won't forget anything in the laundry basket. I just empty the whole thing into the washer. Also makes it easier to see what I have to wash first. I live in Sweden. And here we have sort of a deposit. Sorry if that's not the right word. On most plastic bottles and cans. I.e. we pay like 20 cents for the bottle can. We then return it and get the 20 cents back. Most people keep those bottles and cans in like a wardrobe or such. However, I am terrible at putting those in there. I forget to bring them there and it just starts to pile up. Instead, I had a laundry basket just within reach from my bed. So I just had to lean out and put it in there. Unconventional. But it worked. I have like a million of these weird hacks going. But the important part is that it's okay to do what works for you. It doesn't matter if other people are able to just do it. If it's hard for you, it's hard for you. I've had to explain my solutions a few times. But in the end, most people agree that sure, it might not be what they're doing. But it's better than the alternative. If you fucked up, admit it. Unless you are talking to cops. But in most situations, just admitting how you were wrong and accepting responsibility is so much easier than trying to blame someone or something else or make up an excuse. When you own the mistake, it puts the onus back on the other person to accept that, be mature and move on. If you try and deny or shift blame, it forces that person to examine those reasons and if they are BS, come back at you. Dragging the process out and leading to unpleasant call-outs and confrontations. Regularly change the oil in your car. On time. Do it. Will help it last longer. Edit. What in the fuck? So that's what happens when your inbox blows up. Thanks for the award too. My first.